ki host Poonam Singh. So today we have a very, very special guest, Mrs. Geeta Sachdeva, who is an HR advisor of Morepen. If I have to describe her in one word, and that would be encyclopedia. Encyclopedia of not HR, but for everything. There's a myth that leaders are born. And then there's a second school of thought that all the HODs of the department or any person who is leading a group, he or she is called a leader. So who is a leader?
Actually, Poonam, you yourself have said it's a myth.
Yes.
And I also think it is a myth that leaders are born. So leaders, maybe everybody has two qualities, like there are certain innate qualities. Yeah, there is one thing that sometimes what we feel that there are born leaders, and those born leaders are only those who are political leaders. They get an opportunity to become leader even if they don't possess any qualities of effective leader. But what happens there also? In the course of their tenure, some of them they vanish. Why do they vanish? They vanish only because they think they are born leaders, so they become leaders. But they vanish because they do not possess those qualities which a real leader requires. And another thing is that you have put the another question is that whether the HODs or the people who are leading the teams, they are the leaders. The leader is made, they are not born. And you are made when you acquire all those qualities.
Coming to our core topic of today, first step towards effective leadership. So what are the first step?
See, Poonam, there is a saying that when you know better, you do better.
Yes.
So therefore, in order to be an effective leader, there is one very important step, and that is having the full knowledge, or in fact not full, the deep and critical knowledge or understanding rather, not knowledge, understanding about self, and having the understanding of the people whom you work with or who work around. First step to the leadership is to recognize the potential of people, because when you recognize the potential, you unleash the potential. Recognize the strengths of the people. When you recognize the strengths of the people, you utilize them.
Yes, nowadays the change is so rapid. But why this change is so rapid?
Even the nature of change is changing every day.
Nature of change is changing.
Yes, the nature of change is changing every day. Because in the present, highly scientific and technological pursuits, with the highly technical and pursuits, and especially with the advent of information technology, the leaders in the top executives in any industry and any business, they are facing intense and stressful life. So if you have knowledge gives you confidence gives you a skill of conviction. And when you have all these three things, you are very enthusiastic. And enthusiasm is contagious, and it is required to create the vibrant organization. Enthusiasm also is very important.
What motivated you? What inspired you that you have reached to this level?
So I put a question to my mother one day. I said, why couldn't you do something like this, Amma? Then she said, beta, nahi, maine padhai nahi kari na. कि मेरे को मैं पढ़ी नहीं हम पढ़ नहीं ना औरतें पढ़ती नहीं है तो सो दैट अनदर थिंग केम टू माय माइंड कि पढ़ना बहुत जरूरी इट वाज अ अपहीवल टास्क फॉर मी एंड आई फॉट माय बैटल्स आई वुड नॉट लाइक टू नरेट दैट आई रिवोल्टेड अगेंस्ट माय फादर एंड एवरीथिंग आई डिड मैट्रिक सम ऑडिट ITI एंड प्रोक्योर्ड अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब एंड देन देयर वाज नो लुकिंग बैक आई नेवर लेट एनी अपॉर्चुनिटी गो व्हाटएवर आई हैव टू डू फॉर दैट बिकॉज एट अ वेरी अर्ली स्टेज I understood one thing, that opportunity is like a biscuit in the tea. You dip a biscuit in the tea, fraction of a second delay, it is gone. So whatever opportunities came my way, I did not let even one opportunity go, and I'm that's why I'm whatever I'm telling.